I was born in Strombet City in the year of 32. My folks had little money, and the M's house we well knew. My father could not find a job, though searching night and day. My mother worked a cleaning chair to help to pay our way. And the crying walls of Dublin was a sad and lonely place. I spent my youth with one desire, its memory to erase. If you ever get to go there, where once they stood so grand, see the crying walls of Dublin, and you will understand. My granddad was a union man until the day he died. He stood out on the picket line with Larkin by his side. The DMPs, they battered him, and to his sad travail, they placed him in the crying walls up there in Mountjoy Jail. And the crying walls of Dublin was a sad and lonely place. I spent my youth with one desire, its memory to erase. If you ever get to go there, where once they stood so grand, see those grey Victorian prison walls, and you might understand. If you go to Dublin Castle, where the rich and mighty fell, the walls of that fine mansion, what stories they might tell, of shameless politicians, and some councillors were told, their souls they trade for lucre, and their countrymen for gold. And the crying walls of Dublin was a sad and lonely place. I spent my youth with one desire, its memory to erase. If you ever get to go there, where once they stood so grand, in truth it's more a way of life than you can comprehend. I'm happy and contented with a home to call my own. And we've settled in Australia, where our children they have grown. My dear departed mother, in dreams for her I mourn. But the crying walls remind me, for me there's no return. And the crying walls of Dublin was a sad and lonely place. I spent my youth with one desire, its memory to erase. If you ever get to go there, where once they stood so grand, tell the crying walls of Dublin I've erased them from my mind.